Members of Parliament and others. So the hints you found in the Kenway House lead to the monument.
What a wonderful use of your time, following me around asking obvious questions.
Well, since Henry isn't here, I thought you might enjoy the company.
I don't require any company, and Mr. Green is following up on some leads of his own.
Oh yes, Mr. Green, that's a fascinating idea. Oh please, Mr. Green, come and take a look at this book and stand oh so close to me, Mr. Green.
I do not. Perhaps you have nothing better to do, but I'm busy protecting the assassins.
Are you really? What was it Father used to say?
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission.
Precisely. Anyway, I'm off. If I find any more wild geese for you to chase, I'll be in touch.
Be ever more pleasant for your absence.
Great fire. In an effort to ensure so great a tragedy will never happen again, I would like to thank our esteemed guests, my wonderful Premier Disraeli, members of Parliament and others for being here today. Our proposed legislation will ensure that housing for the impoverished need not be a fire hazard. We have heard your concerns. There is no need for shouting. Please calm down. There's no need for all this disruption. Too many today live in what are little better than hovels, in crowded conditions near open flame, and with few methods of fire control. Will you please stop shouting? That these slums will be replaced with better, safer housing, sanitation facilities, and less open places.
This looks familiar.
Please
It's in the very top. The key to the vault, and the shroud.
Good day, Miss Fry. I'll take that.
You want the shroud to cement your own power. But what if you cannot control it?
And why do you want the shroud? Merely to keep the Templars from having it? How like an assassin. To hold the power of eternal life, and yet be too afraid to use it.
Eternal life? Is that what you think the Shroud offers?
What I think is no longer your concern.
Other plans.
Damn it!